Hello everyone, welcome to another video from DNA Bioscience. This is Suman and today we are going to discuss about the toll-like receptors. The toll-like receptors, they receive the name toll because of the similarity to the protein coded by the toll gene, which is identified in Drosophila in 1985. So these are kind of receptors that have the similarity with the protein coded by the toll gene. That's why the name is toll-like receptor. These receptors are helps to induce the immune response. So let's discuss the points to remember. First one is, these are the single membrane spanning receptors. You can see in this picture, only the single spleen is present. That's why it is called the single membrane spanning region. And why it is membrane spanning region? Because it is present in the cell membrane or plasma membrane. The next point is where they are generally found or where they are generally expressed. So they are generally expressed in the surface of the immune cells, that are the macrophages, mast cells and the dendritic cells. And we already discussed that the macrophages, dendritic cells, they are the antigen presenting cell. That means they recognize the antigen and they present the antigen by the help of the MHC complex. And the next is, they recognize the pathogens that are called PAMs. PAMs stand for pathogen associated molecular patterns. So the toll-like receptor, they detect the PAMs. So the toll-like receptors are also called as the pattern recognition receptors. Pathogen is foreign invader, that may be bacteria, viruses or parasites. So let's discuss the structure. The toll-like receptor consists of three domains. The first part is the leucine-rich repeats. You can see in this picture, this is the leucine-rich repeats parts. In this part, the amino acid leucine is present and it is found in the exterior domain. It is just like a ribbon model of exterior domain. This is the cell membrane, or you can say plasma membrane, where the lipid bilayer is present. This is the transmembrane domain. And the third part is the toll interleukin 1 receptor. So the types of toll-like receptors are, generally 11 types of toll-like receptors are present. The first one is the TLR1, recognizes the peptidoglycan layer of the bacteria in concert with the TLR2. So the TLR1 and TLR2, they are present in the outer membrane and they form a dimer, then they recognize the peptidoglycan layer. The second one is the TLR4. TLR4, it recognizes the lipopolysaccharide pattern. Lipopolysaccharide, we all know that it is found in case of gram-negative bacteria. The third one is toll-like receptor 5 is known to recognize the bacterial flagellin from invading mobile bacteria. So it is found in bacterial flagellin. The next is toll-like receptor 10. It is found in human plasma membrane. The next is the toll-like receptor 3, 7, 8, 9. They are found in the endosomes. And the toll-like receptor 6, they are found in the plasma membrane of the lipopeptides. So this is all about the toll-like receptor. Toll-like receptors, generally they have the capacity to detect the foreign invaders or the pathogens, that may be the bacteria, the virus or the parasites. Then they represent the antigens or the pathogens or the foreign invaders in the surface of the immune cells, that are the macrophages, mast cell and the dendritic cells. And the function of antigen presenting cell, as we all know, that they first engulf the pathogen, they crush off and chew off and make them into pieces, and they represent it in the surface by by MSC class proteins. So in this way, the toll isotope helps to induce the immune response by detecting the foreign inhibitors, particularly the pathogen SPAMs, that is called pathogen-associated molecular patterns. So it is called as pattern recognition receptor also. So that's all about the toll-like receptors. I hope it will help you. Thank you.